What's up guys, tomorrow is going to be the second month of me using the MacBook Pro M1 and there are a lot of things that I'd like to share with you before you consider buying this guy. Just a quick disclaimer though, for all of you watching this, these are all my personal opinions and based on practical and daily use of the laptop. If you're looking for scientific review, I can put up the link above so you can check it yourself. To give you a little bit of backstory, I was opting to get the Razer Blade 15 this year because my previous MacBook was getting temperamental, juggling tasks from Lightroom, Photoshop, and some other. So I thought of selling it and buying a new laptop, which at first I'm very excited about. I was already in the process of getting used to the Windows interface and already checking out some features of the Premiere, which Final Cut doesn't have. But come November, they released the MacBook Pro with M1 chip, which offers tons of update when it comes to performance. So I was stunned and kind of weighing my thoughts between getting it or wait until next year and get the Razer or maybe the new MacBook. But the hype gets in me. I ordered it on silver color, the base unit, and I spoke with my wife, which is typical for me after I order something which she has little knowledge of at first. She convinced me to get the higher end instead. A MacBook came in the post, I returned it, I ordered it again, and it's out of stock. Tried to reorder it at different store, and the only unit they have at the time was the same unit in different color, the gray one. So I am stuck with it. To be honest, I was really impressed how fast the computer is when it comes to editing photos, and I can juggle between applications with ease, and I rarely see the spinning rainbow icon when it's processing. The M1 really is a massive step forwards, considering I have the entry-level MacBook Pro with 8GB of RAM and 256 of storage. Even though it's equipped with a fan, I rarely hear it turned on. You really have to stress the M1 MacBook Pro with something like hundreds of photo exports or lengthy video rendering job to make that spin up. And when it does kick in, it's far quieter than it's usually on Intel machines. Apple has really proved that M1 chip is a powerful beast compared to its Intel counterpart. One thing I also like the most on the M1 MacBook is they redesigned the keyboard, which they first introduced in the 16-inch MacBook Pro. The Magic Keyboard is a way the butterfly mechanism that Apple has been using since 2015, as it riddled with issues that led to key failure due to dust and other small particulates. This one feels much more comfortable to use with more responsive key travel. I must admit, it did make the MacBook Pro 13 as efficient and zippy as its bigger brothers, the 16 inches, and it can even compete with the super spec out Mac Pro. But this machine has limitation. As you can notice, there are still only two USB ports, which kinda disappointing because you still have to carry dongles if you need additional ports. While the other 13 inches version, mainly the Intel ones, have moved to 4. There are also no external design changes to the MacBook Pro, and it continues to feature the same aluminum body with large force touch trackpad, speaker at the side of the keyboard, and 13.3 inch display with slim black bezels. It still uses a 720p FaceTime HD camera, which is the same camera in the previous model, but Apple says the M1 improves picture quality with better noise reduction, better dynamic range, and other features. I have nothing to compare it to, so I searched on YouTube the difference and found this link for you guys to check. For my verdict, it is safe to say that if you have extra couple of pounds or peso to experience these changes, then I suggest you purchase it. But again, if you are considering additional ports or bigger display, then you can probably wait until the third quarter this year because Apple will introduce the new redesigned 14-inch MacBook and upgrading the 16-inch with Apple Silicon. Let me know your thoughts in the comments down below, and that's the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed watching. If you did like this video, please leave the like down below and help me out by hitting subscribe. This has been Reggie. Spread the love, not hate, and I'll see you on the next one. Cheers!